All right, guys, I'm back. I don't even know what part this is. This may be part four. I think this may be part four. Anyway, it doesn't matter. But, yeah, when I left off on the last video, I was talking about Fight Night Round 4. Again, this game, I can't say enough about this game. And I believe it got Sports Game of the Year from X-Play's G4ia. And, I mean, rightfully so. I know it's a lot easier to give a game a better score when it's newer. But, I mean, Fight Night, I mean, this game is awesome. It really is a very awesome game. So, like I said, I would encourage anybody, if you like boxing, to really get into this game. I know there's been a lot of people that chose not to buy Fight Night Round 4 because they removed the whole button punching system and strictly moved it to the analog sticks. But I'll tell you, to me, that total punch control is a lot better. If people would just take a little time to learn something, you will see it's much more rewarding, and you'll get much more out of it. I mean, because with just the flick of the analog stick in certain directions, you can throw every type of punch there is. I don't want to sit and be tapping buttons, you know, all the time to throw a straight or throw a jab. I mean, that's just me. I mean, I think what they did with this game is awesome. But again, one of the good things that EA Sports has been good about over the past couple of years is listening to the community on various forums and threads on the internet. And you know, if there's enough outcry about, you know, this glitch or this option needs to be in there, or why was this taken out, that they all go back in and try to make it right if they can. So there's been rumors, really not rumors at this point, but I think in September they're going to have a patch that they're going to update where you have the option to use the buttons for punching as opposed to the analog stick. I think there are some people that somehow got that option already. I think when the last patch came out where they updated new sliders and stuff, that somehow it got mixed in with that. So some people have this option already, but again, Fight Night Round 4 is a fantastic game. I would give it a 5 out of 5 easily. Not only just because of the play now and the online part, but like I said, that career mode, I was pleasantly surprised when I started my career mode, or they call it legacy mode. Because, I mean, you have a calendar, and it's like sponsored by ESPN. You have ESPN Fight Nights on Wednesdays, on Fridays. You have pay-per-views. You have a ranking system where you can see. It keeps track of every single stat, and it keeps a trending analysis of it. Like, how many jabs you've thrown, how many of those jabs actually connected, how many missed. I mean, it goes throughout your career. You have a bar graph that shows you all this stuff. And, I mean, it keeps your records against all your opponents, and you can see what your opponents are doing. You can see who's fighting for the title. I mean, it's just insane the amount of detail they put in this mode. So that right there is enough to just sell me on the game. And you know, it's just so much fun to play. Okay, so I've got on this jock enough. So let me get off of Fight Night Round 4. And then my last game that I have right now is the NCAA Football 10. I'm a huge football fan, a big football fan. I love college football. I love pro football. I mean, you know, my wife hates the fall time, late summer, because she already knows Sundays, Mondays, some Thursdays, and Saturdays, our time could be limited because football's on TV. So, I mean, she's cool with that. I mean, she knows that's just how us men are. When football season comes around, yeah, we go into lockdown. I mean, so playing this game is very fun, and what really makes this game a lot more fun this year is as you guys have seen some of my videos and heard me mention it before, is a feature that they got that's called Team Builder. And Team Builder, for just to make, you know, put it in simple terms, it's a create a team website. And you take the information from that website that you create a team with, and it imports it into the video game. So for a lot of people like myself, I went to a division two-way college, Tennessee State University. You know, those teams are on the PlayStation 2 NCAA football games. They've always been on those games, but when it came to next gen, they didn't include those teams. I don't know if it was because of, you know, just the size that it would make the disc, because of, you know, it's so much more detail and so much more graphics that they put into the next gen games, if having that many teams will cause the game to not operate like it should. But with this new team builder tool, it has so many features and options. And the biggest option that it has, it allows you to take pictures or different types of art that you got from that either you created or you can snag off the internet, and you can use that for your team. So you guys have seen some videos I got up there where I'm showing team builder stuff while I'll show TSU's uniform, because they have so many different templates for jersey combinations, for pants, helmets. And then you can also do the rosters and the information for this. You can do the stadiums. I mean, it's insane the amount of detail that they that you can use to create a team and import it into this game. So highly encourage you guys, if you're football fans and you like college football, pick this game up. You know, get involved with a team builder. And if you already are, please check out my team builder teams. I take a lot of time into creating them. I scour the Google for my pictures. I also got some guys that run some websites that I can get my helmet art from. My author name is Lux21, L-U-X-2-1. So, you know, check me out on Team Builder. Just put my name in the author section and click search and just check out some of my teams. But there we go, guys. Those are all the games that I have. And I hope that you've had a time listening to me talk. I'm not good with doing that kind of stuff in such a short amount of time. But, you know, trying to fit, I don't even know how many games there were. Were you guys counting? Oh, you wasn't? Okay, I wasn't either. But, I mean, there's so many games that I have that I should never be bored if it came down to it. And I'm never bored anyway with, you know, just me and my wife and just loving life right now. So, but I wanted to at least give you guys an idea of the amount of games that I have. I know that I mainly post on a handful of games, baseball, MLB, 09 The Show, MLB 2K9, Midnight Club, and what else did I put some videos up for? UFC. I mean, I do it, and then I'll do some sporadic videos every now and then. I may throw up a Call of Duty, may throw up a Gears of War or Bad Company or whatever the case may be. But I have a gang of games, and it's just hard for me to get to them all to where I actually have to sit down and record them and then post them on YouTube. But I just want to let you guys see what all I have. You know, again, just bringing you into my world a little bit. Like I said, the basis for my channel was always to be, the way I wanted my channel to be set up was, I used to look at videos on YouTube or around the internet, and I would always be like, man, they always showing games from a certain standpoint, and I never really get to see things from a gamer standpoint. Like, when I'm watching a game, somebody play a video game, I want to feel like I'm right there in the room with them. I want that, and that's how I set my channel up. So when I'm playing games, when I'm commentating or narrating on them, I mean, it's just like I play them with you there next to me. Or I play them first time run throughs. I don't try to play a video game and, you know, I want to wait till I do things just perfectly so I can put it on YouTube so I can seem like a big shot, like I'm a complete expert and, you know, I'm a master at video games. No, that's not me. I'll just post it. Fuck it. I don't care. You know, my thing is I want you to see what the game is about, whether I'm good in it or not. I just post it and you know, you can get out of it what you want. But that's your boy, Mr. Lux, and I am tired. My throat is hurting like a motherfucker. I cannot talk this long anymore, but I got to give you guys what you need to see, and that's all the games that I got for the 360, and I haven't gotten any new games for my PlayStation 3, so I still have these right here. I mean, I've downloaded a couple demos, but these are the PlayStation 3 games. So, my next game I'll probably get for PlayStation 3, once I play those a little more, probably be Infamous. But again, I want to start spending more time with playing games that I have before I keep buying all these new games. And I also want to get Ghostbusters for the 360. All right, it's your boy, Mr. Lux, signing off. Peace, love, and hair grease. Y'all be easy.